Hi guys, good evening, welcome to StunnerShare. Today we are going to see a video on technical analysis. The last two classes of technical analysis, what we have shared is, one is called as candles, wherein like I will be telling about what is a green candle, what is a red candle, and what are the two candles and how you have to see a candle, and what does a green candle mean, what does a red candle mean. And then I have told about the trend. One is uptrend, one is downtrend, another one is sideways. So there are only two candles, which is red candle and green candle. Green candle is bullish candle and red candle is bearish candle. That's it. And I have also told about trends. The going up means uptrend, going down means downtrend, and then the sideways, wherein the correction actually happens, and after the correction the uptrend may change to downtrend or the uptrend may continue to uptrend. Clear? And now what we are going to see is support and resistance. So basically, what does the support means, what does the resistance means, just ask yourself. I will also try to tell you what does the support and what does the resistance actually mean. So let me take this. Clear? So what does the support means? See, support, I will not talk about the jargons in trading or share market or stock market. I'll just tell about what does the support mean, what does the support actually mean in a basic material thing. So support means you are going to support someone, like you are going to give a helping hand to someone to encourage him or to motivate him. So you are just supporting him, you are just guiding him, you are just like giving a helping hand. So support means, so support, S means you are just helping them. So I will apply that in stock market. So assume a price is coming down. Clear? So here you, the market or the players in the market, like retailers or the investors, feel the price whichever has fallen is now at the right place to go up. So the people come inside this place and started buying this stock or buying this price. So when they are going to buy this, it is creating a support. So there are bunch of players comes inside and started buying that stock. So because of that thing, a support is formed. Clear? And see how this support is formed. These are like historical references. You need to go and check a lot of historical charts, and then you will be able to understand what is the support actually mean. Clear? And what is a resistance mean? Resistance means, see, in normal basic language, resistance means someone is stopping you. Okay, someone is stopping you, that means resistance. So if the price is moving up, people feel the price is too costly to buy and no one enters to buy, and by that the stock comes down. So people are giving some resistance, saying that you are too costly, I don't want to buy you. So people are coming out of the stock, so the stock is facing a resistance. Okay, so just I'm telling about the very very basic thing. A support means people are thinking that the stock should not go below this price, so we are going to buy this. Okay, assume an iPhone, whenever it comes into the market, it is 1 lakh rupees. Okay, there will be few buyers can buy it, can afford it. Okay, after some point of 6 months or during a festival period, the stock price comes in, the iPhone price comes down to 70,000 or 60,000, people go and buy it. Clear? And that is where the support, people feel, okay, this area, this price is like a correct value, so I can buy. Okay, so if suppose assume the gold for resistance. Whenever the price is very cheaper, people will be buying it. Now the price of gold is very high. Do you think people will go and buy now? No, they will not buy. They feel that the price is too high, I am not ready to buy you, please come down. So support means you are going to help the stock not to fall down. And resistance means that is the limit you can go, you have to come down. Okay, so every where every stock, every any stock in the market will have support and resistances. There are numerous supports, there are numerous resistance. So you can ask a question, whether the support will never be broken or the resistance will never be broken. My answer is, support and resistance are for to get or to get broken. They both will get broken at one point of time. Okay. See, initially the price of the petrol was 70 rupees or 40 rupees. It was not going up. Now it has reached 80. So the resistance was broken in touched 80. Now from 80 it can come again to 70 and then it can go to break 100. So the price can break support, the price can break resistance. There is no terms and conditions or no point there. It will never get broken. It will for sure get broken. Yeah. And for example, recent example, take onion. Okay. Onion price was going very, very high. Per kg 200 rupees. Okay. And now if you go and see the price, it will be around 100 or 70. So it has taken a resistance, people are not buying it, onions are not selling, so the price started coming down. Apply support and resistance in your day-to-day life. You can see daily something related to support and resistance. Okay, so this is all about support and resistance technical analysis class I have told. Kindly ask any doubts if you have any questions in the comment section. If you feel the content is good, kindly give a like. If you want to share this knowledge to your friends and colleagues or family, kindly do a share. And thanks for subscribing. Keep supporting. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for more videos.